Well, you are now looking at a Windows 11 machine. You will now lose your marbles and your shit and your titties and everything and becoming really, really angry at me and yelling at me for why are you a Linux YouTuber and using Windows? I'm not a Linux YouTuber. I just love talking about Linux. That's why I primarily talk about Linux, but I'm a tech guy. I love all operating systems, even the ones that do bad things to you behind when you're sleeping and taking your kidneys and stuff like that. I do talk about the subject I'm going to talk about right now on and off, but the last 3 or 4 or 5 months, I kind of got a little bit boost on subscribers count. So there's probably a lot of people that don't go back and watch my old content. I understand that. So I'm going to talk about how Windows and virtual machines stopped my distro hopping. And I talked about how virtual machines stopped my distro hopping before. But I kind of want to put Windows into this mix because I kind of have settled as Windows as a host. Naughty boy. What are you telling me? You're using Windows as a host? Yes, sir, I am. Why? There are things that I do on a daily basis, or almost daily basis, and programs I use, games I play, things that I have to do that makes my life easier, less convenient, and faster that Windows just do better than Linux. The video editing software that I use run best on the Windows. It gets better rendering time on the hardware that I have and so on and so on. There's a lot of tools that I use both for music and games that I play that either don't work that well under Linux or it just works better under Windows. So I'm all for using the best tool for the job. So if Windows is the best tool for the job, I use Windows. So I can't live without Windows, but I can live without Linux, but I don't want to live without Linux. Meaning that Linux is not doing something for me that I can't do on any other operating system. Or Windows in my case. But Windows is giving me something I can't do satisfyingly or at all under Linux. I do test Linux, you know, once in a while to see if I can change my work schedule and my workflow and my work habits over to Linux. It is like before it was this big of a gap and it's slowly shrinking. And if things go the way they are right now, like within like maybe 2, 3, 4 years, I can probably run Linux full time. And I have run Linux full time from 98 to 2010 and 11. And then I started to dual boot up to 2006, 2007, 2018. And then I went to the paradigm that I'm doing right now. And between that period of time, if there is a distribution on DistroWatch, not DistroTube, but on DistroWatch, I have probably installed and run it as my main system for like a day or so. Probably, or at least in a virtual machine. So what you're looking at right now is my day-to-day setup. It's Windows 11 in the back end, and then I have my virtual. And I have found the perfect mix of the virtual machines or the distributions I want to run within a virtual machine. I rarely download new distributions anymore and try them out because I'm getting my fix from all of these distributions that are in here right now. I will just mention them because the naming scheme is not really indicative of what it is because I change them and I don't change the naming scheme of them. I'm lazy like that. So OpenSUSE Pantheon is basically just OpenSUSE with whatever desktop environment I like to run. Right now it's KDE. Ubuntu is Kubuntu. And I have them here in the order that I use them the most. So I use OpenSUSE Tumbleweed the more than I use Kubuntu and stuff like that. So this is the ascending order of how what is my most preferred systems right now. And it, like in, let's say, in a month or 6 months, I may put PopOS on top. Right now, I would probably put PopOS down here. It's already changed. Now I'm talking to you guys. So OpenSUSE Tumbleweed, Kubuntu, Manjaro XFCE. It's Manjaro KDE right now. Just haven't bothered to change the name. PopOS I'll put as number 4th. Ubuntu GNOME, just a stock standard installer of Ubuntu. I think I have themed it, but it is in case that I want to show something on Ubuntu where I feel that it's necessary to have an Ubuntu install that is as vanilla as possible. So I tend to reinstall this quite a lot. Fedora is a distribution I run for like I boot into it like for a week, every day for a week or so. And I'm like, yeah, I got my Fedora fix. And then I run out of it. Leap is kind of like a little bit, again, mostly for videos. test stuff out in Leap, how to install a newer kernel, how to get newer software, because I know that there are still a lot of people that I talk to and my viewers that are interesting and are running Leap, so I kind of like to have that there to mess around. Debian testing is Debian testing. It's either Debian stable or Debian testing. It depends on what mood I'm in. But it's mostly also just to test Debian versus Ubuntu and what the Debian world is up to. I don't really use it that often. Solus down here is basically just my test. I should rename all of those, but it's my test distribution VM. Right now I have Linux Mint, the latest version. I think it's 22 or 21. I can't remember what it's called. It's the latest one that I have installed there just to see what the Mint people are up to. And if you see me trying out a new distribution, it's from this VM. The SUSE build down here is not really SUSE, it's Windows 10. Like I said, my naming scheme is all over the fucking place. Yeah, this is my Windows 10 machine, and why do I have that? Well, so I can showcase stuff off on Windows and don't have to use my physical, you know, machine here to do it, where you guys can see all of my open windows and shit. Like Linux, this down here is my retro VM. I rarely use that anymore. I used to do a little bit of a short series where I looked at retro Linux distributions, you know, 32-bit Linux distributions, Linux distributions from the 90s and early 2000. I may get back to that at some point. But it's basically set up so I can install. You can see I tried to install OS 2 WAP 3 is the latest one I tried to install on this one here. But it's basically my retro OS VM. But having this layout here and having this paradigm here stopped me from distro hopping. Because let's say I want to do something and I'm like, you know what? I feel like Kubuntu today. I just boot into Kubuntu and it's set up as I like it. It has all the programs that I like and it has sync folders that I sync all the time. So if I'm coding and stuff like that, I can access my coding folders and stuff like that via my NAS on all my system. So if there's things that I want to do, you know, work things or hobby things and stuff like that, it don't matter what distribution I'm on because the files are located in a central place. So I just boot up Kubuntu. And if I'm like, oh, I just noticed something new came up in Tumbleweed, you know, they got an update, so let's say KDE or Cinnamon got an update that I'm really, really interested in. Boot out of Ubuntu on the VM, boot back into Tumbleweed. While all of this is going on, I am now looking at you guys on my second screen. I have Discord and all of, you know, YouTube open. Right now I have OBS open over there also, but I have basically my social media over here when I'm not having OBS open. So I can change the operating system all the time without actually rebooting my computer, meaning that I can have an email correspondence going on here, I can have Discord conversations going on here on my second screen. My life don't get interrupted every time I need to reboot. Because if I ran, let's say, these distributions, let's say I want to run Fedora today, I have to reboot, go into Fedora, start up my, you know, Chrome or Firefox, open up Discord, open up Steam, you know, open up Epic game store down here, you know, open up all these things, get what I'm saying here, and then do the things I want to do on the Fedora. I'm like, oh my god, vanilla Ubuntu, there's something I have to test and check out. Yes, I could start up a VM for within Fedora. Or I'm like, oh my god, this is something that I really, really need to be done, but I can't do on the Fedora, and I have to live in vanilla Ubuntu for a while, I might as well just reboot. So then you reboot into Ubuntu, you have to close everything down, reboot into Ubuntu and open everything up. Can you do the same with Linux as a host? Yes, I could. I used to have Pop! OS was the last host system I had instead of Windows 11. I ran Pop! OS. And I did the same thing here. So instead of having Windows handling all of my background tasks, I had Pop! OS handling all my background tasks. And then I just, you know, open up a VM. Because all my VMs is located on a separate SSD, so I can access my virtual machines from both Windows and Linux on my physical hard. What I found out is that I always, during the day, had to reboot into Windows. The longest I could go without having to reboot into Windows was 1 or 2 or 3 days, at most. Then I had to reboot into Windows, like I said, to do work stuff. I see my YouTube channel as work, so it could be working for something for my YouTube channel. You know, there's this game I really, really want to play, you know, and I haven't played it for 3 days and I'm getting itchy because I really want to play it and it's not working that well under Linux or at all under Linux, so I have to reboot to get into that. Or if I'm doing a game with some friends and it, again, it only works under Windows and I can only play multiplayer to the same satisfaction under without stuttering and stuff like that under Windows, I have to reboot into that. Again, like I said, the gap is narrowing, but it's still not there yet for the things that I do with my computer. May not be your case. I just realized that, well, why not just run Windows in the backend? Because I could do everything I want with Linux more or less in a virtual machine. So when I started to run Windows, back then it was Windows 10 as my host, and just run all of these virtual machines here, slowly when I figured out what distributions I used the most, and this is like trial and error. You know, I went through like a period of 6 months where I just installed one distribution after another, and then slowly I realized which distributions I didn't delete again. You know, what VMs didn't I delete again? So I had a Solus down here. Well, that got written over quite fast. I had Endeavor OS. That got written over, you know, repurposed for another distribution really fast. I had the MX Linux. That got also repurposed for another distribution really, really fast. And then I was like, well, what's this? What distribution am I booting into on a weekly basis? And all of them I boot into on a weekly basis. I would say the only one, there are three distributions. Five VMs I don't boot into on a daily basis. And it's these last five here. It's more like a weekly basis or on a necessary basis. But Fedora, GNOME, like Manila Ubuntu, Pop OS, Manjaro, Ubuntu, and SUSE, the first three here I boot into almost on a daily basis. They go at most one day between I boot into them. Pop OS and Vanilla GNOME and Fedora, at least two or three times a week I boot into them. And I spend sometimes 10, 15 hours in these distributions up here. So I'm using them heavily. But like I said, for what I need to do with Linux, I can do in a VM with no problem whatsoever because I don't game. I don't need hardware acceleration for what I'm... graphic card acceleration for what I'm doing with Linux. I don't game under Linux. But this cured my distribution hopping, and it cured my rebooting of my computer. This may come as a shock to you guys and girls, but I run Windows for, well, right now it's been up for 7 days. It's not uncommon for me to run Windows without having to reboot it for 2, 3, 4 weeks, 20 days. On average, I think I reboot my computer every third week, and I don't experience any slowdowns, anything like that. And I have a video coming up about that, why I don't experience that, like a lot of people say. My computer runs as fast, it runs the videos as fast, and it runs Linux VMs as fast as it did the day I booted it. I just don't get why people have so much problem with the performances on the Windows. They must be doing something, or I'm just lucky enough to be able to not being doing shit, you know, that slow down my computer. So I can run Windows almost 24/7, and my computer, like you can see, is running 24/7. And I can run all of these magnificent Linux distributions. I can run two of them at the same time. So I do that sometimes. I run Tumbleweed and Ubuntu, or, you know, two different distributions if I want to see how is the, let's say, GNOME in Ubuntu versus GNOME in Tumbleweed, or what is the difference between some software packages or packs, you know, a collection of software in Tumbleweed versus, let's just say, an Arch install. So I can have, like, you know, one of them over here and another one on the other side here, like split the screen, and then I'm running two distributions at the same time to test it out. Again, yes, you can do that with a Linux host. Yes, of course you can. But like I said, I just need Windows. I can't live without Windows, and it kind of irritates me, but I can. Windows 11 and virtual machines have stopped my distro hopping. And I haven't looked back. I haven't had the need, or I haven't had like the urge to install a physical Linux distribution after I did this here. I do have Linux on my laptop. I have right now it's running Manjaro. I'm thinking about changing over to Pop OS. But I'm running Manjaro on my dual booting Manjaro with Mac OS on my old 2011 MacBook Pro. So I do run Linux on physical hardware, but it's mostly for my laptop. I actually use Linux, the Linux partition, more than my macOS partition, because the laptop is so old that macOS is a little bit sluggish on it. And I had to do, you know, the patch version of macOS to run somewhat of a supported macOS version. Again, another talk. So I do run Linux on physical hardware. Don't be like, oh, you don't. I do. But mostly I'm running Linux in a virtual machine, and it does everything I need it to do. While I don't have to, you know, take down and interrupt my communication and my work or what you will call it, my social life, if I want to reboot, I just close down the VM and I can run 1, 2, 3, 4 different VMs at the same time. You get what I'm trying to say here. So yeah, for me, this is the perfect mix. Living both in Windows and Linux at the same time. And before you say, oh, Linux in a virtual machine is not Linux, of course it is. If you're running Windows in a virtual machine under Linux, you were still running Windows. Like, I don't know why. Like, I see too many fucking Linux users. I don't run Linux Windows at all. No, I'm a Windows-free existence. And then you see them boot up into Windows to do a tutorial. And like, what is this that did? It's in a virtual machine. Then you're running Windows. You're doing stuff on the Windows in a virtual machine. You're still running Windows. Oh, well, it's not the same as on real hardware. It is. It is. It's not like you. It's not like when you're running Windows and Linux in a virtual machine that you know. It's like a watered down version of Windows or Linux you're running. Ubuntu in a virtual machine is the same as Ubuntu on physical hardware. You can do exactly the same thing. You can't. The only thing you can't do is run World of Warcraft, for example, unless you pass through a graphic card, because you don't have the graphic card power to it. So what you're running here is basically a really, really good 4-core 8-gig RAM system with crappy onboard graphics. That's the only difference. You have crappy onboard graphics. So it really makes me laugh that, oh, you're not really running Linux. Okay. You believe that? It's cute that you think that, but yeah, okay. If Linux in a virtual machine is not really Linux, then most servers nowadays are running a virtual machine. So that means that almost every server company is not really running Linux because they are virtualizing them. I'm basically just doing what the server world have been doing for fucking probably a decade or more now. That's what I'm doing on a home basis. I'm virtualizing my OS existence. When you buy a server that's run Ubuntu, it's more than likely, I'll probably say a 90%+ chance that instance that you have now bought, like a 4-core, 8-gig Ubuntu server, is booted up and run in a virtualized, containerized way. And the host OS could be anything from FreeBSD to Windows, even fucking Mac OS in some instances. You just bought an Ubuntu installed, where they have an automated tool to set up a VM, a container, installs Ubuntu for it, and you have access to Ubuntu. So yeah, I'm doing what the corporate world have been doing for probably over a decade now. So yeah, it's cute that you think that this is not like running Linux for real. Really cute. Like, I just want to hug you right now. Anyway, see you all later. Bye-bye.